hop Miami Beach. Yeah, yo. Talk crazy on tweets. They don't want it cause I come to defeat.
They don't want it.
I peep, you need style sweet. Bamboo sticks out in the Jeep. It's a new weirdo every week. Get the whip, put it up for my seeds.
Put it up.
No cure for the IG disease.
No cure anything for clout. They do anything for clout. Do anything for clout. They do anything for clout. Do anything for clout. They do anything for clout.
Welcome back to another episode of Actually, the first episode of Breakdowns with Ty, where I break down my favorite videos that I've done. I may start breaking down other videos, but I'm gonna start with myself. And this first video is Nicole Laeno. It's Offset featuring Cardi B, Clout. That's the song I did this to. So I'm gonna break down a few parts of this video. I wanna keep it under 10 minutes, preferably between 5 and 10 minutes, and give some good information of how you can also make videos like myself. So I wanna share that with you. Future videos may be on Patreon, but I know this one definitely is on YouTube. That's where you're watching right now. Okay, so first thing first, I'm gonna show you how to do the spark and the smoke. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mute these two layers. I already got them muted, and I'm gonna start everything fresh except the mask. I'm gonna add the mask on because that's time consuming and I'm trying to keep this video short. So what you do first is on a layer on, I use MacBook. So I use two fingers to right click. And then you do new, and you do new solid. So you can name this, let's say, intro. And it's already gonna have the right aspects. Keep it black, and then press okay. So you're gonna see this, don't panic. All you do is right here, you click on normal, and then you click on screen. Boom, now you're here. So let me cut this real quick. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna grab these masks, jump on here. So all I did is paste the mask. So let's say you drew the mask, and what you're gonna do whenever you draw the mask, open up this all the way, and you wanna click the mask pad. For those of you that aren't new, aren't seasoned with After Effects, the mask path is basically you can make it change at certain points. So as you see, I got 4 points right here. This is the beginning. It moves a little bit right here, moves right here, and finally right here. And the reason you want to have the mask path is because you can track it and it look like it's part of the video, not just stationary. So the way that you actually draw that, let me just show you real quick. If you don't know, I use pen tool. So with pen tool, again, I'm using the Mac. I'm not using like any board or anything. I'm just using straight computer. So you draw and you pull. So when you pull, it actually makes it curve. And then you can make it curve like that. Another way that you can do it, which is rare, but you could just tap. And if you tap, it's straight line, so you can't make any curve. And that doesn't really work with video because nothing really goes away unless you're adding these effects to like a building or a structure that's, there's no curves. But more than likely, you're gonna use curves. So again, pen tool is located right here. You drag to actually make it, and then you can come back and click on these. You can click on these and lessen the curve. Okay, so say we have that. The next thing you do is Saber, and I use Video Copilot Saber tool. You drag it over, boom, it's there. And with Saber, you have all these different automatic plugins, so you can add this to anything. Add this to any of your pen tools to make any type of different look. So just play around with it, get creative, do your own thing. The way that you get it to attach to that particular layer is you go to customize core, open that up, core type, layer mask. Now it's added to the mask and I do not need that second mask. So now that you have it here, what you wanna do is you actually, cause if you notice on mine, let me mute this real quick. On mine, that's the smoke layer. You see it's sharp. It got a little sharp effect. The way that you make it sharp, let me show you real quick. Mute that. I don't even know why I said mute. So let me show you. So what you do is you play with the insides. So the lower you make the insides, the sharper it gets. You can't really tell until you click off. So you see, it's sharp right here. And if you were to move it in, you can definitely tell. So that's how you make it the sharp look. That way it looks like it's actually moving through. And the smoke layer. And actually what I'll do is I'll show you the layer that I already did. So let me mute this and go back. So this is that spark layer. So you also set keyframes for that. So go down to effects, let me show you Saber. This is if you want to change this customized core. And basically everything down here is the same thing as up top. So you got the start offset, the end offset. So the way that I do it is I usually do my start first. So it's looking this way. So start at zero and end at zero, and then you keep going. And right here, I got it going forward, and the end is right here. So it's keeping it small the whole way. And then you can make this, like if you want to extend it, you can do all that yourself. But these keyframes are the ones that I have for this. So boom. So you keyframe it to make it smooth. That's how I get my videos, my animations to be real smooth, because a lot of people use the paint tool. With the paint, I had problems there. Some of my first videos, you'll see it, but I didn't really like it because you have to be like right on point to make it look smooth, because if not, it looks jumpy. So this is a way for it to look smooth, as smooth as you can get. So that's the spark layer. Let me go back, and now let me show you the smoke layer. So the smoke layer is pretty much the same exact thing, and I'm gonna keep both of them on. The only thing is on this, I changed it to, I believe, Nebula. Yeah, Nebula. So Nebula is down here. And you can change the color and everything. So I keep the color the same so it looks like it's the smoke from that. So again, this is the same exact thing. Let me show you real quick. So you go down to effects, customize core, same thing. I turned the keyframes on so that you can show the drag, and these stay longer. So as you see, I have it ending a lot different than the spark layer. The spark layer is ending here. This one takes a lot longer. So it's going, and then it ends. So with smoke, of course, smoke is gonna still be there. So you wanna keep that in mind and let it keep going. And I keyframe this to make it still look like it's moving with her. And the end point is way back here. And that is how, that's the breakdown of how I did the laser, spark, and the smoke. It's very, very simple. So just run it back. But this is my first one, so I'll keep doing more. Another one I may do in the future, maybe next week, is I'll do a breakdown of how I do like figures. So like that tree, the palm tree, I may do that one. And also the skyline, that is the Dallas skyline. Hope you guys like that Dallas skyline, baby. But I'll do those in the future. I just wanna keep these short and on point so that you, if you do have some fixed stuff, if you do have specifics you wanna work on, you can easily look through it. And again, if you are new to this page, make sure you subscribe for more information, like this, share it so that others can view it, because I want everybody to be able to do what I am doing. I believe in like sharing your gifts, so I want to continue to do that. So any requests you got, go to my IG. If you see a video, just share with me, message me and say, hey, can you do a breakdown of this part, and I'll start working on those. So again, thank you for taking the time out. I am going to have a Patreon that has more detail, but I want to thank you for tuning in. Thank you for guys that have been waiting. I know you guys have been waiting on this, like some of you guys have been waiting for like 2 months. So let me know how this worked, and then tag me in the videos that you do. Let me know, like either tag me in a post, comment, get my attention so I can see what you've learned. I appreciate it. Thank you to all the animators out there. Respect the videographer, respect the animator. Let's get it.